What's up, guys? It's Brianceum here, and today we are back in Skyrim. That's right, you guys, and no snap. It's gonna be an awesome freaking day. So, guys, welcome back, and happy freaking Friday. So, if you're a bit new here, we've been doing showcases all week, today being the last day for the kind of new showcases, and then on Saturdays, we're going to be back to normal with our home showcases, and it's gonna be pretty great. So, Monday through Friday, 12 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, come to the channel, check out a new mod each day, and have fun with that. So today we're not taking a look at an armor, we're not taking a look at, you know, a follower or a place or a home or anything like that. No, today we're taking a look at a singular weapon, but a very high resolution looking weapon, and one that I think fits into Skyrim's lore pretty well. It's known as the Scythe of the Crow Mother. So the Scythe of the Crow Mother is a scythe, which we've seen here before on the channel back when I was originally doing a lot of showcases, but this is not a craftable item. However, you can upgrade it inside of the forge, which we'll take a look at here soon. But the place that you want to go ahead and come to find it first off is right here. You want to find Cradlestone Tower. Now, Cradlestone Tower is a lovely place where a not-so-lovely hag raven is living, and you'll want to dispatch her as soon as possible. Now, you're close to Markarth as well as probably maybe Falkreath down here. It's actually kind of like equidistant between the two. And maybe between Morthal as well. So take your pick. Any of the holds will do. So Cradlestone Tower is where you're going to want to go ahead and come to find it. You're going to want to go ahead and shimmy on up these stairs. Say hello to Martha. And then come on up this way. And when you've found the illuminated body, looks like it's holding and clutching its groin there. When you go ahead and find that, you'll want to go ahead and approach it and pillage the remains. So the Scythe of the Crow Mother has now been added. Now, before we go ahead and take a look at that, let's go ahead and take the cheat god off so we can take a look at it, you know, with its current stats. So the Scythe of the Crow Mother does a base 28 damage, weighs 12, and then has a value of 100. However, this twisted great scythe that came from a plane of oblivion, the master of that place wields a great scythe herself. The weapon causes gushing bleeding to most foes. So this thing is quite large, because it is a great scythe, not just a scythe, and you can really see, it's kind of a pretty looking blade. However, we're going to take a look at this inside of the forge, just to make sure that we can see how we upgrade it, and then we'll take a final look at it together with a nice character who's kind of been specced out to look like someone who should wield a scythe. So we're back in the forge here, and we're going to take a look at what exactly you can do to go ahead and upgrade this bad boy. Now, it would pretty much be okay to assume that in order to upgrade it, you do indeed need access to the Daedric Smithing perk inside of the smithing section, because it only unlocks the ability to improve it in the Daedric section of the crafting area. So if we go ahead and come on down here, inside of the Daedric section, all the way at the bottom, we find the Scythe of the Crow Mother plus 1. Now this upgrades its ability from 28 damage to 34, and it requires 1 empty petty soul gem and 3 silver ingots. So let's go ahead and upgrade that bad boy. But then, say we want to go even further. Scythe of the Crow Mother plus 2 requires the Scythe of the Crow Mother plus 1, who would have guessed, and then 1 singular lesser soul gem and an additional 5 silver ingots. Let's go ahead and make that. Next is 3 quick silver ingots, 1 common soul gem that's empty, and then the Scythe of the Crow Mother plus 2. Are you seeing a theme here? Scythe of the Crow Mother plus 3, 1 empty greater soul gem, and 5 more quicksilver ingots. And then soon we can finally reach our main and, you know, desired thing with the Centurion Dynamo Core, which can definitely be seen as one of the more expensive ingredients that you need in order to upgrade this bad boy. But you need 1 Centurion Dynamo Core, 1 empty grand soul gem, and then the Scythe of the Crow Mother plus 4. And now it has reached its final stage. So the plus 5 version of the Scythe of the Crow Mother does a whopping 68 damage, weighs 12, and is now worth 500, as opposed to the original 28. Now let's go ahead and put it up on a weapon plaque, and we'll take a look at it up close, and then we'll battle test it, okay? So, I figured one of the best armors that would pair well with this scythe is probably the Daedric armor. However, some of the mods that might look better with this is the Black Mage armors. They would probably give you that kind of almost Grim Reaper look whenever you're holding the scythe. But honestly, if we go ahead and take a look at this bad boy, or this bad girl, I should say, When we get very close to her, you can really begin to see the detail that has gone into crafting this scythe and making it look as good as possible. And boy, does it look a bit rusty. So if the person doesn't die of bleeding, they're gonna die of tetanus if they're not up to date on their shots. Holy crap! But I do like the design that comes all the way up kind of the centerpiece of the blade. And then as it kind of weaves its way down, it's really, really cool. It's just a wrought iron, basically like a wrought iron fence in your hand, attached to a bit of a wooden stick. That kind of looks like you took it straight from Groot's arm. But honestly, it's a nice looking scythe that is just gigantic. I mean, the fact that it's this big is kind of crazy, honestly. But the whole blade itself is really cool, not only because it's free, but the fact that you actually can upgrade it into its, you know, final form. I do kind of wish that it added things each time you upgraded it. So, like, the first one does bleed, the second one does fire, the third one does life absorption, everything like that. That would have been really, really cool. But I really do think the holes in it are one of the most interesting aspects of it. Because when you think of a blade, you want it to be a solid chunk ground down and sharpened to be this form-fitting thing that goes in one way. But with this hole, with all of the holes in the scythe and kind of the unevenness of it and, you know, the jagged edges and everything like that, it's just, it's absolutely just a bloody weapon and it will make someone bleed a lot. So we're actually going to go ahead and test that out on a couple of different foes and we'll take a look at it, what it looks like in action. But honestly, just based on how it looks, tell me you guys wouldn't download this mod just to have it in the world. It looks beautiful on a weapon black, and I think it would look perfect in any of the homes that we've showcased. Well, I'm pretty sure my pants would be perfectly shat if I saw someone running up to me with a freaking scythe in their hands like this. So I'm not in god mode, but we're going to go ahead and test out the scythe of the Crow Mother on these lovely, unopposing bandits. Just to go ahead and see what happens. Okay, well, we one-shot her. Let me just double-check that I'm not in god mode. So she didn't really take all that that much killing, but I would like to see if we can, like, make one of them bleed, you know? Like that? That'll be two-shot him, okay. Now, so far, it's been pretty nice. This guy's probably gonna kill me. Oh, no, disregard. We put the entire wood part into his head, but not the scythe part. I think that's probably the only unfortunate part about modded weapons, is they don't always follow where the blade goes. So it's kind of silly sometimes. Oh man, he's a powerful boy! So there you have it. The Scythe of the Crow Mother is probably what you'd find similar to like a greatsword that's been tempered and or a battle axe. It's not really the greatest in combat, but then again, it was showcased on like a level 17 character, so take that with a grain of salt. No, nothing leveled into two-handed attacks, so it could absolutely be a beast to be reckoned with when it comes to leveling up your two-handed and everything like that. But let me know what you guys are thinking down there in the comment section. Did you like it? Did you hate it? Would you use this mod? And would you use it for combat, or would you use it more so for show? Because it's a pretty small mod, and it can kind of fit in perfectly with, you know, if you're going for a super heavy kind of, what's the word I'm looking for? Demonic kind of demonic playthrough, or if you just want to touch it or look at it, you'll get tetanus. Just be careful, kids. Don't touch it. So guys, until next time, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next showcase.